Whoa! It's almost time for my show!
Hello everyone, Jack here. Welcome to a look at episode 1A of the Patrick Star Show, Late for Breakfast. So the Patrick Star Show is trying to be its own thing while paying homage to the OG SpongeBob SquarePants. It's Patrick, but now he's a child living with his parents and little sister and cranky old grandpa. He even has a pet urchin, which allows for us to get this Ren and Stimpy close-up and a reference to the famous James Joyce novel Ulysses for you literary critics out there. I would be remiss not to mention that the urchin itself is a reference to the surreal SpongeBob episode Eek an Urchin, where SpongeBob and Mr. Krabs have to deal with an urchin infestation at the Krusty Krab. For some reason, there's a Pee-wee's Playhouse store in Patrick's room that takes him to different places. But one could also argue that Patrick's entire room is a reference to Pee-wee's Playhouse, so we'll just leave it at that. So remember how Nick advertised to us that Patrick would be having his own TV show inside his new series? Well, he does have his own show, but it turns out that he and Squidina are not broadcasting it on TV. Instead, Patrick's room is basically a giant TV, and he performs for his onlookers outside. If there are any. If anything, it's just Patrick and Squidina playing pretend instead of broadcasting on public access. Well, this is kind of a downer. It doesn't really have much impact inside the show as Patrick does his own thing to entertain the viewing audience. I guess Patrick will just have to put some work into organizing and making compelling episodes of his show before he can make the big time. While Patrick is busy concentrating, Squidina shows us a commercial, which is clearly recorded from TV using a VHS tape, and the commercial is about the chum bucket with our good friend slash parasite from the original series, Sheldon J. Plankton, as he tries to trick you into thinking that people actually come to his restaurant. It's a funny bit, and recenters your focus when you watch it. After the commercial break, Patrick goes backstage to have breakfast with his family. As parents for Patrick, Cecil and Bunny are nothing to write home about compared to Herb and Margie from the original series. But considering the wild and wacky direction that the Patrick Star Show is going, it was necessary to switch Patrick's parents into dumber and goofier caricatures of themselves, as Herb and Margie are too down-to-earth and sensible for this type of show. They also seem to be dumber than Patrick, which may be problematic down the line, but other shows have had dim-witted parents and have done just fine. While Patrick's new parents and sister are questionable at best, the new edition of GrandPat Star is a welcome addition. Voiced by Dana Snyder of Aqua Teen Hunger Force fame, GrandPat brings a vibrant amount of humor to the main ensemble. The second half of the episode is about Patrick searching for food after being late for breakfast. GrandPat tells a dubious story, which allows for the return of Squidosaurus Rex from the second movie, and he, like Squidward, plays the clarinet badly. The story inspires Patrick to make something to eat on his TV show, allowing us to see that Patrick had more creativity as a child, or maybe that it is just that he now has main character powers. Well, he does get food eventually, except that it is literally cooked trash. And to wrap up the episode, his dumb parents forgot who he is while they watch him sleep, and I have a feeling that this is going to be a running gag. As a whole, Late for Breakfast has pilot episode written all over it. The main cast and premise of the show are introduced in a clear and concise way, even with the wild and wacky overlay. You get a feel for what the characters are about. Cecil is a dumber Patrick, Bunny is a well-meaning but also dumb housewife, Squidina is a savvy manager, and GrandPat is a crazy senile old coot. And Patrick is, well, Patrick. You've been watching him for 22 years at this point, I shouldn't have to explain Patrick's star to you by now. As well, the theme song is kind of bland. It lacks the in-your-face annoyingness that SpongeBob's has. But I gotta say that I enjoyed this episode. It's not quite the same thing as SpongeBob, but I have to give the show credit for trying to go in its own direction and being out of the box. It doesn't adhere to the rules of the SpongeBob universe, but that's okay because it doesn't have to be SpongeBob. It shouldn't be SpongeBob. It should be something new and different. So I'll give this spin-off a shot, at least for its first season. Okay everyone, those are my thoughts on episode 1A of the Patrick Star Show. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button. And if you want to see more of my content, click the subscribe button. As well, let us know your thoughts on the first episode of the Patrick Star Show down in the comments below. This is Jack turning off the TV. See you all next time.
Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to Binging with Babish, where this week we are once again playing with fire in the form of a simple traditional regional Italian recipe. Trenete al pesto is a simple enough dish, but as usual with Italian cuisine, the devil is in the details.